We're following breaking news right now out of Washington, D.C., where a magnitude 5.3 earthquake has been felt in the D.C. area. The Pentagon has been evacuated. We were just talking to Senator Coons of Delaware, who, like so many others right now, slightly shaken by the tremors that they felt. The senator telling me live that the ground literally shook beneath them. Andrea Mitchell, as you also well know, would normally be live during this hour. She's now on the phone as her show was interrupted as a result of this. Andrea, can you tell me what you're hearing and what was even felt at our D.C. bureau there?
Cameron, I've never felt anything like this. We're all safe. We're outside. We were on the air, as you know, and started everything started shaking. The desk, the cameras, the floor, everything around me. And you know our studio on the third floor here of our building on Northwest D.C. It was shaking so demonstrably that my papers, my scripts, everything around me was just bouncing up and down. At first, I wasn't sure whether... It never occurs to you when you live in Washington that it's going to be an earthquake. And then people, our technical folks, started coming in and saying, it's an earthquake, get out of here. And they grabbed all of us, and we started going down, walking down three flights of steps. We're all now outside, a couple hundred people from the Washington Bureau here in Washington, D.C., having experienced, I think, our first earthquake. We're told it was 5.8. I guess that will be clarified later as they begin to make measurements.
That's what we're hearing as well. Well, Andrea, I'm also getting word. I'm getting word that there are people who are in North Manhattan who are also saying that they felt something there as well. So all of these details are coming in to us. But 5.8 magnitude, Andrea, I'm not sure if you even heard our interview with Senator Coons, who was originally on to talk about the breaking news out of Libya and certainly had to switch gears and tell us what was happening there. He heard sirens on the Capitol. There was an evacuation, at least toward the end of our information. But what's going on there, Andrea?
Well, at this stage, we are all outside. We've all been cleared from the building. Everyone here is safe. We don't know of any injuries reported anywhere else in the immediate area. And I think that given what has been experienced elsewhere in earthquakes on the West Coast and elsewhere throughout the region, we've seen, you know, the devastating earthquakes. This was not damaged. I don't see any cracks in the building. We certainly didn't see anything coming down. It was just a noticeable shaking, I would say, lasted probably upwards of a minute, maybe no more than that. And it took a while for many of us, especially when you're doing a show and you're focused so much on live interviews. I was just finishing my conversation with you on the Dobbs Fair down in Miami and preparing to talk to other guests and wrap up the show. So we've had a lot of breaking news today out of Libya, and we were focused so heavily on all the developments there. It just didn't register for a while that this could possibly be an earthquake. Something I've lived here now for 40 years. I've never experienced anything like that in Washington.
Well, I got an email just from Willie Geis, our colleague, and he said he felt it in New York. His walls in his apartment shook for about 5 to 7 seconds, no damage and nothing since. But I believe Willie is near the west side of Manhattan, and he is emailing me saying that he felt the tremors there. The USGS map shows that the earthquake centered near Charlottesville, Virginia. That's what they believe. I'm also getting information that Capitol Police are evacuating the U.S. Capitol, which we got the heads up from Senator Coons that this was happening. The U.S. Capitol building has been evacuated after the tremor violently shook the building. Light fixtures were swinging, and the building shook, according to this report, for about 15 seconds while the tremor hit. 15 seconds in a quake is a lifetime, especially when you're in a part of the country that is not prepared for it, and certainly you're not expecting anything of this nature. I also got this in from Jim Mikleshevsky. He's saying that his wife and son, they're in northern Montgomery County, said that the earthquake lasted at least 1 minute. That's what it felt like to them there. And they could not stand on the floor. It is the same area which was the closest to the epicenter in the quake that happened about a year ago. So these are some of the details that I'm getting in just from our colleagues, Andrea, in the area, people who are in Manhattan, like Willie Geis and Jim Mikleshevsky's family, who apparently they're near where the epicenter of last year's quake, which I'm working to get all of the details on this, but I'm hearing repeatedly mild tremor, but extremely violent. And at least in the Capitol, there were chandeliers and light fixtures, I should say, affected by the trimmer itself. So hopefully no injuries here, but we're still waiting to get some more details. So, Andrew, what are they telling you at our bureau there?
Well, everyone here is outside, but let me just restate that in terms of where the leaders of the country are, we know the president is in Martha's Vineyard. The Secretary of State is in New York City, at last report. Leon Panetta is in Monterey. She was giving several speeches today, and was the Defense Secretary, of course, is very near his home out there in Carmel Valley, California. The Vice President was in Mongolia and is going to be on his way back from Asia, but that's where the Vice President is. Most of the leaders, the Speaker of the House and the others, are in their home districts or on congressional tours or on vacation. So this is a downtime in Washington, but there's no question about national leadership in terms of where everyone else is today. Very few people in the
Andrea, you mentioned Martha's. You mentioned Martha's Vineyard, Andrea. I just got this hot note in that they felt a tremor in the press workspace in Martha's Vineyard. So now we have a great portion of the East Coast where people are reporting that they felt these tremors. And, you know, I'm standing not very far from Congresswoman Maxine Waters. Did you mention everyone is kind of spread out? You've got members of the Congressional Black Caucus here in Miami with this, and they're all, like the rest of us, kind of baffled by the news coming from Washington and the area, but also trying to clamor to get more details. But we also have a picture of the National Mall. This is where people are being evacuated. And I believe I've got Pete Williams on the ready to talk about the information he's been able to gather with all that's going on. Pete, are you there?
I am, Tamron. So far, we've not heard of any serious damage here in the Washington, D.C. area. This earthquake was centered to the south of us in Virginia, near Charlottesville, Virginia, which is where the University of Virginia is. We haven't heard yet from university officials about whether there's any danger there. We're actually in a part here in Washington, D.C., where NBC News is. We're right next door to the Department of Homeland Security in Northwest Washington. It's sort of a high point of the city. And several DHS employees are outside their building as well. I just talked to one of them on a cell phone who said they were ordered outside their buildings. They're in an old U.S. Navy facility that was hastily converted to the offices of Homeland. They say they haven't heard of any damage, and the response around town has varied. I just talked to some folks at the U.S. Supreme Court. They were not evacuated. The justices aren't around in the summer, but a lot of staff is there. The Capitol was. The people in parts of the Pentagon were. Other federal agencies, it seems to vary, but so far we have not heard of any reports of damage. But as you say, it's so unusual here. My colleague Kelly O'Donnell, who spent many years living in Los Angeles, you know, it was nothing to her. It was no doubt that it was an earthquake to her. But for many of us who have lived in Washington for decades, this is not something that we're used to feeling here. It was it started out very gently. We could feel our building rumbling. It was as though you were in an area where a freight train was passing by, is the only feel I can come to it. And then it became pretty clear that it was an earthquake. And I have to admit to you, I did briefly dive under my desk, having seen all those public service announcements about what to do.
You did the right thing.
I did briefly dive under my desk. And then when it was pretty clear that it was over, we started working the phones. But so far, no reports of damage here in the D.C. area.